Welcome to a new PowerPoint tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the ruler as well as the guides, grid line, and smart guides to create faster presentations. Now, all of these tools combined, they're going to help you create better aligned slides, especially when you're working on infographics and diagrams, and you want things to snap in place, and you want to have equal size boxes that are equal height and width, and all of these are going to help you create that. So let's start with the ruler, because the ruler will control how the other elements will work. Now, if you can't see the ruler like I have here on my screen, I have a horizontal and vertical ruler. All you have to do is go to any slide on your presentation, right click, and make sure that the ruler is checked. So if it's checked, you'll see it. If it's unchecked, you won't see it. Now, if you don't have that option, you can also click on the view in the ribbon on your PowerPoint, and you'll see another option where you can either make the ruler visible or not visible. So if I check the ruler, now you can see it. Now, in some cases, you might not see the vertical ruler, and that could be part of your settings. So if you can't see it and you really need to see the vertical side of the ruler, then I recommend you go into your PowerPoint settings and click on the preferences or the settings if you're on a PC, and you're going to see an option under view that's going to show you other options that you can check. You can see here right now, ruler, show vertical ruler. Now, if I uncheck it, you can notice it'll disappear. And if I check it again, I'll be able to see it. So do keep that in mind, that some of the ruler settings are also controlled from the preferences. So now let's talk about the ruler size. Now, if you're a designer and you've worked with other design tools, you might be accustomed to seeing the 0 point on the ruler start here on the left. Some designers like the 0 to be right at the margin, some like it to be at the page, some like to even move it to the right, especially if they're working with languages that read right to left. However, with PowerPoint, we don't have that luxury yet. The 0 is set, you cannot click on it and move it, and also the size of the ruler or the metric system on the ruler is set. With PowerPoint, you can only have inches or centimeters. You cannot have pixels or points. So if you wanted to change that from centimeters to inches or the other way around, maybe you're working on an international project, you can do that from the settings. So check out the Microsoft website, because your computer might be different. But right now, if you're on a Windows, you'll have to close PowerPoint so that the settings take effect, and then go into your computer control panel, and you'll be able to follow the guidelines. And what you're really looking for is the language and region, because the language and region will dictate how the measurement, as well as the temperature controls on and the time and the calendar on your computer. So all of these are controlled by your computer. Now, if you're on a Mac, you'll also have to do the same things. You can go into the system preferences and look for language and region. However, if you're on the web, right now the web only supports inches. It does not support centimeters. That's why I always recommend, when you're working on design projects, to always work on a desktop version. Keep the web for when you're sharing the files. So now that you know how the ruler is set up and the measurement as well as the 0 point, well, what about the size? Now, the size of the presentation is dictated from the page settings or the slide size. And there's two different areas to locate that. You can click on the file, page setup. If you are on a Mac, you'll be able to see these options. And if you're on a PC, you'll be able to click on the design, and you'll see an option here that says slide size. And when you click on it, you're going to see the two most commonly used sizes, which is the standard, the old one, and the 16:9 widescreen. Now, the widescreen will work very well if you're creating a YouTube video or a webinar and you want to export it to that size. However, if you're going to a custom conference or you want to create something for print, I recommend you click on the custom. Let me show you once again. You can click here on the page setup. Now, I know this could be confusing, because you can see here it's called slide size, and then here we have page setup, but they're really the same thing. So click on it, and now you'll have more options. You can choose some of the most commonly used print sizes, letter or poster, the A3 or A4. These are all common print sizes. Or if you're going to a place where they're using a projector screen, you can ask the organizer if they're using a 16:9 or 16:10 or the old 4:3. And if you're lucky enough to be designing a presentation for some of the new conference rooms, you can click on custom, and now really you can make this this any size you want. So ask the organizers, because sometimes you might be better off creating one very wide presentation, or in some cases they might ask you for three or four presentations that could be shown side by side. So do ask the organizers about that. For now, I'm going to go with the white screen, which is the most commonly used size, and notice that now it's showing me 13.33 inches wide and 7.5 high. Now, these numbers are going to come in handy when I'm working with my guides and when I'm using mathematical formulas to calculate how many columns and rows I want on my slides. Now that you know how to set up your ruler, let's talk about how you might use it. Now, the ruler is going to come in handy when you right-click on your slide and you say Grid and Guidelines and you choose Guides. Because you'll notice that by default, PowerPoint is going to place two guides, and both at the zero point, horizontally and vertically. And with the ruler allows you to click on any guide, and now you can see with precision where you want to place it. For example, if you want to place it at the 6-inch point, now you'll be able to just let go and move that guide. And having that ruler will allow you to have that precision. Now, on a slide like this one, the guides will come in handy because you can start moving the guides and placing them visually of where you want the content to be, especially on slides where you have manual text boxes and icons, because this slide is using right now a theme with a title and subtitle, and everything else is placed in here manually. So this is where, if I click on reset, only the title will reset. Notice if I do this and I say reset, only the two parts that are part of the theme will reset. Everything here has been placed manually, which means I have to move it around manually. And this is where the guides could come in handy. And the good news is you can right click again and you can add as many guides as you want. So for example, if I wanted another horizontal guide, I can do that. And now this will give me a little bit more control of how I want things to appear. And if I wanted to center items as well, this is going to help me create this more of a manual grid system that works for me. So for example, if I can have another vertical one, you'll notice I can always move it here and then make things align based on the guides. Now, some people like to use the align here. I use them all. I use the combination of the align feature. I use the guides. And there's another area where you can use the grid system, which I'll show you. So this is one application of the ruler where you can, it will help you see where the guides are. However, the application that can come in the most handy is when you're setting your bullet points. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to go into the View Master, Slide Master, and I'm going to show you how we can use the ruler to set the hierarchy in the bullet points. Now, by default, PowerPoint gives you 5 levels for the bullets on the first slide. And what you do on the first slide, which is the parent slide, will impact the rest of the text boxes on the rest of the presentation. And this will also translate on the front end. Now, the front end is the normal view. So this is the front end of the presentation. This is the part you're working on. And the back end of the presentation is the theme. So you're going to click on View, Master, Slide Master, and this is the theme. And this is the back end. So this is what controls the fonts, the colors, and the layouts. Now notice what's going to happen when I'm on the first parent slide and I click on the text box, which is part of the main theme. These 5 elements, the title, date, footer, page numbering, and text, I highly recommend you keep them. And by controlling them here and designing them, they're going to impact the rest of the presentation. So now let's go to the text box, and I'm going to zoom in and show you how the ruler can come in handy when you're working with the bullets. Now, notice what's going to happen when I click on the first line. You're going to notice that the ruler is activated, and now I can see I have 2 triangles, the top triangle and the bottom triangle. And by clicking on the bottom triangle, I can move the text away from the bullet. So this is going to give me a precision of how far do I want the text to be away from the bullet. And the same thing happens with the second line. So for example, if I wanted the bullet to be closer to the text here, I can do that. And if I wanted to space things out, then I'm able to control them here with the ruler. So this is another application that gives you that precision with the ruler and having these numbers in place. Now let me revert back, because I wanted to mention another question I get, which is, what is the difference between the ruler or the margin? Now if you right click on any text box and you right click and you say format shape, you're going to see another menu, more specifically this one here, which is called, let me just hover, size and properties. Now if I click on it, you're going to notice that there's an option at the the bottom that says text box. And this text box has an option with left and right margins. So if I click on the area where we had the bullets and I move the left margin, notice that all the bullets are moving. So this is the difference. Now you know that if you're changing the margin, everything moves. Now, I recommend you keep these settings by default because most people don't know how to change them. So if you change them, you can mess up other people's files. So do keep the settings here as they are. And if you wanted to change the bullets, more specifically line by line, this is where the ruler could come in handy, and you'll need these two triangles. And this is only going to work on the horizontal ruler. Just keep that in mind. So now you know how to use the ruler on the back end, as well as how it can help you with the guides. Now, what about the guides? Because if you take a closer look, you're going to notice that the guides are not really going to help us on all the slides. Because notice I set the guides on this slide, but when I go to the other slides, it has the same guides. And maybe I want different guides on different slides. Now, unfortunately, PowerPoint does not allow that. It only allows you to have one set of guides on the entire presentation on the front end. However, on the back end, it allows us to create custom guides per slide layout. So let me show you what I mean. I'm going to go in here right now and delete these guides so that we can go back to the back end and set universal guides for the presentation. So if you wanted to delete the guides, all you have to do is click on them and just click and drag them off the slide, and now they'll be gone. Or you can right click on them and you can say delete. So in this case, let's just move them all. And now let's go back to the back end of the presentation. I'm going to show you the difference of creating guides on the front end and the back end of the presentation. So notice by deleting them, I have deleted the guides on all of these slides. So now let's go back to the back end of the presentation and see the difference, because this could be a useful tool or it could be frustrating in some cases. So I want to show you how to troubleshoot it. Let's go to the master slide. Now, if I go to the top slide and I right click here and I wanted to choose guides, let's just uncheck them and check them again so that we can see them. Notice what's going to happen. Right again, by default, PowerPoint has put it at the zero point. And because it's the parent slide, it's also going to impact the rest of the slides. So if that's not what you want, I recommend you don't put any guides here on the front slides. It could come in handy if you wanted to have guides on the margins. So this could come in handy putting it on the parent slide, because if you set the margins here, then you know that they're always going to be in the same location and no one can delete them. Because notice what's going to happen. If I go into any slide, now they all have that guide. But because it's red, I can tell that it's part of the theme and I'm not able to move them or delete them. So that's why I'm saying it could be frustrating, because I've had some people message and saying, how do I delete these? And they're not sure how to delete them. So that now you'll know that they could be set up in your theme. So go back to the master slide, go back to the top slide, and make sure you don't have any guides here. Now, you can have a little bit more control, for example, on slides like this one, where we have a content boxes with three levels. Or if you wanted to have a guide and you're creating diagrams and you wanted to make sure that no one goes out to this corner or this corner, this is where you can now add guides to specific slides only. So I'm going to right click here and I'm going to say guides. Let's just uncheck and check it again. And now notice that the guides are slightly lighter. They're not red and they don't impact the rest of the presentation. However, they are part of the theme. So if I click here and I make them here on the margin and I set here the margin, now what's going to end up happening is if I go to the front end and I choose a slide, let's just choose a slide, which is this one here. Where is it? This one here that I was showing, notice that this one only has the guides, whereas the others don't. So now you know how you can use the guides with a little bit more precision and how you can impact them, whether you're using them on the back end or the front end. However, the feature that I like the most, that I use all the time, is not the guides, it's the smart guides. So let me show you what's the difference. Now, if I right click here and I say smart guides, I'm going to have a feature that's going to allow me to create alignment without even any ruler. So I don't even need to see the guides. All I need to say is smart guides. Let me show you what I mean. So for example, if I click on this box here now and I move it around, I really don't know, is this really lining up? Is this really the right size or not? I can't tell. But if I right click on the slide and I say here, here, smart guides, notice what's going to happen. Now when I'm clicking, can you see these red arrows? So now right now, PowerPoint is telling me that there's an equal distance between the boxes. And now if I click on this box and I start expanding it, notice how it's showing me that the red box, the red arrow is the same size as the box next to it. So now I'm able to create these alignments without even having guides, because PowerPoint is giving me these on-demand guides, which is a little bit more useful. And I really do like that, and I use this feature the most. Now, something else that could come in handy is the grid lines. Let me show you the difference between the grid lines and the guides. Now, the grid lines are there set by default, and they're also controlled by the ruler as well. So if I click on grid lines, notice how I'm seeing the grid lines, and they are going by inches. Notice because I have an inches, my grid lines are also in inches. And I have the option to right click and say, let me just click, make sure I'm not on the box, right click, and I'm going to go into the guides, and I'm going to say a grid options. Actually, let me click at the top so you can see it. I'm going to right click here and going to the guides and grid options. Now, this grid options might be visible or not visible on your computer. If it's visible, you can click on it and it's going to help you control the elements of the size of the grid. So this is where you can make it custom. You can go with inches. You can really resize anything and it'll be controlled by your ruler as well. Now, if you're on a PC and you cannot see this option, you can click on the view, and right here below the notes, you're going to have something like an arrow. You can click on the little arrow and it's going to open that guide for you. So I'm not really sure why it's so different on a PC, on a Mac, but that's how it is. So on a PC, click on the little icon here. On a Mac, you can right click and you can choose the grid options, and this will help you. Now, if you choose snap objects to grid, notice what's going to happen. Now I can see the grid. If I take this box, no matter where I move it, notice how it's snapping. And this is going to make it so much easier for me, because now I know that it snaps to the grid and things are lining up. And the same thing with this object as well. And using the snap to grid with the smart guides, you can see here how I can create things that are lined up and aligned, and it's going to make it so much easier for me. And you can see here, it's showing me that I have equal distances based on the arrows, the red arrows as well. So now you can see how with the combination of the ruler, the guides, and the smart guides and the grids, really you can have a little bit more control. And depending on the type of designers you are, you can choose what is the better option for you. Congratulations, now you know how to work with rulers, guides, and guidelines better than most people do. And if you need any support with your presentation, strategy, content, or design, I'm here to support you. Check out one of my upcoming workshops or done-for-you services. Until next time, ciao for now.